Hey y'all, I'm Jody Wolfborn, and this is the fourth video in the Getting Started with Habitat series. In this video, the studio will start playing around in the HabCLI's studio. To follow a text-based guide and to earn some sweet badges, visit our free online tutorial site, Learn Chef Rally, at learn.chef.io/modules/try-habitat. And to follow along with this demo on the Habitat site, go to habitat.sh/demo/packaging-system. The Habitat Studio is a clean, self-contained environment in which you can develop, build, and package software that is free from any upstream operating distribution. All of the tools and dependencies included in the studio are installed through Habitat packages, thus preventing any upstream dependencies from being used by your package. If you're on a Mac or Windows workstation, ensure you have Docker installed and running, and away we go! We'll be using the sample application that we forked in the last video, Getting Started with Habitat, the plan. If you haven't already done it, clone that repo now to your local workstation. Then, on your command line, change to the root directory of that Habitat project repo. For those using Docker, we can configure our workstations to expose port 8000 so we can see our sample web app in a browser by typing export hab docker opts equals dash p 8000 colon 8000 on a Mac system. And $env:/hab docker opts + =-p8000:8000 on a Windows system. With that configured, we'll open our project in the studio by using the hab studio enter command. You'll notice that Habitat imports the required origin keys and also starts a supervisor service in the background. We'll talk more about the supervisor in another video. Now, we'll run the build command to build the latest version of our application, along with all of its dependencies. For repos with multiple application layers, we can specify the app we want to build by passing its directory name here. For example, build chef.tv/sample-plan. Otherwise, the build command will look for a plan.sh in the current and underlying Habitat directories. Once the package finishes building, it'll write the newly built heart file to the results directories in both the studio's working directory and in your project repo. And the last step is to start our service and verify that it runs in our browser. Type hab service load your origin and your app name. And when it loads, type hab soup status to verify that your app is running in the studio. From a browser, navigate to localhost port 8000 and see your app in all its glory. To stop the service, type hab service stop your origin and then app name. And again, hab soup status will show us that the application is in fact in a down state. So now that you know what the Habitat Studio is and how to build and manage services with it, you can start making changes and deploying new builds using the supervisor. Watch the next video in this series for more info on the supervisor, and go to the docs at habitat.sh to dive even deeper. Until next time, I'm Jody Wolfborn. Bye!